Okay, kelas hari ini kita akan belajar chapter yang baru iaitu trigonometric ratio. Okay, why do you learn this topic? Because trigonometric ratios allows problem related to length, height and angle to be solved by using a right angle triangle. Okay, so trigonometric concepts are used in the field of navigation, aviation, engineering, astronomy, construction, and so forth. Okay, for example, you want to know the height of a building. So, kita akan guna trigonometric ratio. Ataupun, we want to measure the width of a river. Okay, kita akan guna trigonometric ratio. Dalam bidang astronomi, trigonometric ratio also digunakan, okay, untuk tahu the distance between planets, stars and so on. Okay. Alright. Now, sine, cosine and tangent of acute angles in right angle triangles. Okay. Bila kita sebut trigonometric ratio, it must be related to a right angle triangle. Okay, because trigonometric is referred to the right angle. Okay, angle in the right angle triangle. Okay. In Form 1, you have learned about Pythagoras theorems, and in that topic you have know what is hypotenuse. Okay, the hypotenuse is the longest side of a right angle triangle. So in this triangle PQR, PR is the hypotenuse. Okay, alright, now we want to know which one is the adjacent side and opposite side. Okay, to know the side, we have to know which angle that we refer. For example, now we refer to this angle at R, which is angle PRQ. Okay, when we refer to angle PRQ, okay, QR is the adjacent side because it is adjacent to this angle. QR is the adjacent side for angle R. Okay, and PQ is the opposite side. Okay, because this angle, angle R, so PQ is the opposite. It is opposite to this angle. Alright? Okay, let's say we refer to this angle, angle RPQ. When we refer to angle RPQ, okay, hypotenuse dia tak berubah. Hypotenuse is the longest side of the triangle. Okay, ataupun dia yang opposite dengan the angle of 90 degree. Yang tu adalah hypotenuse. Okay, so PR is the hypotenuse. Okay, PQ, side PQ is the adjacent side because now we refer to angle RPQ. Okay, this one is the opposite adjacent side. And side QR is the opposite side because it opposite to angle RPQ. Okay? Okay, now let's discuss on example 1. Identify the opposite side, adjacent side and hypotenuse based on the given angle in the table below for all the following right angles. Okay, now you have triangle ABC. Angle BAC, angle B AC. So the angle is at A. The hypotenuse is AC. Opposite side, when this one is the angle, so opposite side is BC. And the adjacent is AB. If angle BCA, so angle at C, angle at C remains the AC is the hypotenuse. Opposite side for angle C is AB, and the adjacent is BC. Okay. For the triangle KLM, angle LKM, so angle is at K. Angle at K, hypotenuse is KM, opposite side is KLM. Okay, LM, because the angle is here, angle K, so opposite is LM, and the adjacent is KL. Okay, for the angle LMK, so angle at M, hypotenuse KM, opposite side is KL, and the adjacent is LM. Now, triangle PQT, so you refer to the small triangle. Okay, the small triangle PQT. Angle TPQ, so angle at P, hypotenuse is PT, opposite side is QT, and adjacent is PQ. For the triangle RQS, the hypotenuse is SR ataupun RS, and then opposite QRS, so angle at R, the opposite side is STQ pun boleh ataupun SQ ataupun QS. And the adjacent is QR. Okay. Alright. Next, I want you to do this exercise. Mind test 5.1A. And you have to determine which one is hypotenuse, opposite side and adjacent side. Okay, let's discuss on brainstorming one. This brainstorming one, you want to know the relationship between acute angle and the ratio of the side of triangle. Right? The steps: draw a right angle triangle PQR, where PQ is 16 unit. Okay, and the length of QR 12 units. Draw a few straight line parallel to RQ, label as R1 Q1, R2 Q2, and R3 Q3, as shown in diagram below. Okay, so this one is the diagram. Okay, now we want to look at the ratio between the sides of right angle triangle. Acute angle, okay, now we refer to acute angle QPR. QPR, so angle at P. Okay, R1 Q1, okay, this one is 3 units, over PR1, okay, how to know the length of PR1 by using Pythagoras theorem, PQ, 4 units, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 units, and R1, Q1, this side is 3 units, So 4 square, square root of 4 square plus 3 square. Then you will get the side of the this side, the hypotenuse. Okay, you get 5. Okay, that's why this one is 3 over 5. The ratio between adjacent side and hypotenuse, PQ1, 4 units over PR1, 5 units. So 4 over 5. And opposite side over adjacent is 3 over 4. Okay, now you have to complete all the value in this table. Okay, this one what you will get. Okay, all right. 6 over 10 simplified, you get 3 over 5. 8 over 10 simplified, you get 4 over 5. 6 over 8 you simplify, you get 3 over 4. Dan yang lain-lain pun sama. Okay, awak akan dapat this answer. Okay. So, what is the patterns of your answer to the ratio of the length of opposite side to the hypotenuse? This one, opposite side to the hypotenuse. Apa yang awak dapat? This one, 3 over 5, 3 over 5, 3 over 5, 3 over 5. The value is constant. Okay, angle dia tetap angle yang sama. Yang bezanya apa? The length of side. This one length dia 3 units, 5 units. This one 6, 10 units. Okay. Tapi bila kita simplify, kita akan dapat the same value. Right? And then the ratio of the length of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse. Okay, the ratio between adjacent side and hypotenuse. 4 over 5 you get. Okay, this one also 4 over 5. 4 over 5 and 4 over 5. So the value is constant. And the ratio of the length of opposite side to length of adjacent side. Okay, semua ni awak dapat 3 over 4. So the value is constant. What happened if the size of angle is changed? Awak rasa kalau, okay, value of angle, sorry, the size of angle is changed, what will happen to this value? Ataupun the ratio of the sides. Okay. When the size of angle is changed, the value, the ratio will change. Okay, so based on brainstorming one, it is found that given a fixed acute angle in right angle triangle on different size. So different size means that the side of the triangle tu tak sama. Okay, the ratio of the length of opposite side to hypotenuse is constant. The ratio of length of adjacent side to hypotenuse is a constant. And the ratio of the length of opposite side to the length of adjacent side is constant. The relationship of the ratio obtained from brainstorming one are trigonometric ratio known as sine, cosine and tangent. So apa yang awak buat tadi dalam brainstorming one is the trigonometric ratio. Okay, macam mana dapat value sine? Value sine is ratio between opposite side over hypotenuse. Cosine, ratio between adjacent side and hypotenuse. While the tangent is ratio between opposite side and adjacent side. Okay? So, how to remember this ratio ataupun how to remember the trigonometric ratio. Okay, the formula is SOHCAHTUA. Okay, SOHCAHTUA. So, macam mana dapat sine? Sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Okay, awak baca macam ni. SOH. So. Kah. Tua. Okay. So, to find sine, opposite over hypotenuse. To find cosine, adjacent over hypotenuse. And to find tangent, opposite over adjacent. Okay. Itu formula yang mudah untuk awak ingat trigonometric ratio. Okay, now example number 2. Complete the following table based on the diagram on the right. Okay, you have triangle PQR, angle Y, this one angle X. Okay, sine X, sine X. Macam mana nak dapatkan sin X? Okay, ingat balik formula tadi. So, kah tua. So, to find sin is opposite sides over hypotenuse. Sin X. X is here. So, opposite is RQ. And hypotenuse is RP. Okay, ataupun kat sini QR over PR. Okay, cos X. Cos is adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent is PQ, hypotenuse is PR. So PQ over PR. Tangent X. Tangent X is opposite over adjacent. So tangent X is QR over PQ. Sin Y. Sin Y. Y is here. So, untuk dapat sin, sin is opposite. Opposite is PQ over hypotenuse PR. Cos Y. Cos is adjacent. Adjacent over hypotenuse. So, QR over PR. And tangent Y. Okay, tangent Y. Tangent opposite PQ over adjacent QR. Okay, senang saja untuk dapatkan sine, cosine and tangent kalau awak ingat this formula. So, kah tua. Okay. So, next you have to do mind test 5.1B. Okay?